Hello, everyone. Thank you for tuning in for our first ever video Q&A on the census release of retail sales. I'm Bill Thorne, NRF Senior Vice President of Communications and Public Affairs. And joining me today is Mark Matthews, NRF's Executive Director for Research, and Jonathan Silver, CEO and founder of Affinity Solutions. Mark, Jonathan, welcome.
Thank you so much, Bill.
Thank you.
So before we get into the October numbers from the government, I have to say this has been a big week for NRF and Affinity Solutions. On Monday, we announced the launch of the CNBC NRF Retail Sales Monitor powered by Affinity Solutions on live TV. This is a brand new analysis for monthly retail sales that modernizes how retail sales are tracked and measured. And we also rolled out NRF's new Center for Retail and Consumer Insights, which will be NRF's hub for data-driven insights into the evolving retail industry and the consumers who drive it. Mark, I want to start with you. Could you talk a little bit about why we launched this effort and what does it represent for the industry?
Thanks, Bill. So, you know, as a researcher, probably better than most, I get the value of using traditional tools like surveys to measure what the consumer is doing and what the consumer is thinking. But over the past decade, we've seen a proliferation of modern alternative data sources that allow us to look at consumer spending with a much higher frequency and significantly more granularity than what we had previously. And when it comes to retail sales, you know, most of the country for decades has been relying on the Census Bureau and their retail sales survey, which comes out once a month. And this data arrives, 2 weeks after the month is over, and it really only gives us a top level view of what's happening, in retail sales. And, I've always felt that that's something that we could really improve on. And as the association that represents the retail industry, it's really our responsibility to share insights on what the consumer is doing. There's no industry that's closer to the consumer than retail, and retail is such an important driver of the U.S. economy. Almost 70% of GDP is consumer spending, and retail is a significant proportion of that. So having better data is really critical for all of those of us who watch the economy and are trying to understand its direction. So by working with Affinity and their amazing data set, we're able to have a much deeper understanding of what's going on with the consumer. Their data is, almost real time, and it has demographic data attached to it, which allows us to actually look down and understand what's happening with consumer spending. Is it strengthening because lower income households are spending more? Are consumers rotating from services into goods at a higher degree than they were before? Are consumers cutting back on recreational spending to spend on essentials? All those are examples of insights we can gain using the Affinity data. So I've got to say, we are really excited about where this partnership can take us.
Let me complete that sentence for you, that nobody is closer to the consumer than retail, and nobody's closer to retailers than the National Retail Federation. So it does make sense. Jonathan, you have a lot of experience in the world of consumer data. Could you give us an overview of why Affinity Solutions was able to partner with NRF and CNBC to come up with the Retail Monitor?
Sure, Bill. Happy to do that. First, let me just step back and explain a little bit about Affinity Solutions and how we have this data. We're talking about 140 million credit and debit cards, 8.8 billion transactions a year. We track 4,200 retailers. The power of that data to drive decisions, both visibility on what's happening at in the economy, but also solutions that retailers can use to run their businesses more effectively, was extraordinary. And so the opportunity to work with the NRF, we launched a groundbreaking partnership on Monday that we announced on CNBC. NRF, the foremost expert and leader in retail intelligence, Affinity Solutions, the leader in consumer purchase intelligence, and CNBC as a third partner bringing those insights to their audience was groundbreaking and exciting. The Retail Monitor, which is really the view of what's happening in the economy, which correlates so well with publicly available data, is really about modern retail. It's about giving tools tools that are not static, that are dynamic, that are flexible, that are fast, to create this new era of data-driven insights for the retail industry and for those of us who watch the market and the economy.
It's really, really exciting to see what we were able to come up with and the value that it brings to so many, whether it's to, you know, Wall Street, whether it's to industry analysts, whether it's to our members themselves. It's valuable information that they can count on. And this is something they've been looking forward to for a long time. Now, thank you both for the kind of the background. Now that this is launched, however, and we're out in the public eye, what exactly did the Retail Monitor tell us about October sales, and how does it line up with the latest numbers from the government?
It's interesting, Bill, that you mentioned that, because as we know, Census released their data this morning. And, you know, as we saw, you know, the numbers told us what we already knew a week ago, because we had the data from Affinity. You know, we knew that retail sales saw a slight slowdown in October, after a, you know, surprisingly robust September. Now, you know, this really shouldn't come as much of a surprise to us particularly, because when we compare the census data to the Affinity data set, we find that there's a 0.98 correlation for the raw unseasonalized month over month numbers. So very, very high correlation between census data and Affinity data. So again, no real surprise that you know, census came in and essentially told us what we already know. You know, if we look forward, you know, we may see some variation between Affinity and Census. You know, we can't expect it that it's always going to move in lockstep. But, you know, what we've learned, you know, working with Affinity and running the numbers all this time, is it's an extremely accurate indicator of consumer spending in retail. But, you know, just back to the data itself, you know, what we saw in October probably wasn't a surprise, because, you know, retail prices have been dropping pretty dramatically. You know, there's almost no inflation right now in retail goods. And in some categories, we're actually seeing deflation. So, you know, comparisons are going to be harder, you know, as we move forward and prices soften. But, you know, one thing we're pretty sure of is that the consumer is going to be reaching into their wallet, you know, come holiday season. NRF has forecast 3-4% growth for the holiday season, and we're pretty confident that that's where it's going to end up.
Jonathan, do you have anything to add to that?
The census data that just came out in terms of year-over-year growth is, you know, essentially flat, but month-over-month growth essentially flat, 2.6% year-over-year growth. What's really valuable about our data, and we're going to get into this more next year with the monitor, is to start slicing and dicing it in ways that no other data set can do, looking at not just by category, but looking at, you know, household income and age and other ways of slicing the data. One area that we do look at as a sort of bellwether or leading indicator of the economy is durable goods. And we saw, you know, categories like home furnishings, electronics, with a downward trend ranging from 1.3 to 1.4% monthly, a 5% drop compared to last year. While that's not great news, it's actually better news than earlier this year, where we saw a double-digit decline earlier in the year in those categories. So it's actually not so bad, right? It's less bad. We look at the food service sector. We're seeing some different trends. There was a 2.3% growth in restaurant spending. That's the lowest annual increase we've seen so far. So people are starting to shift their spending habits. Menu prices are up 6% over the past year. So people are more price sensitive. They're starting to eat out less. Grocery store prices haven't risen as much. They're up by 2.4%. And as Mark said, you know, a lot of the inflation has really come down pretty dramatically. So you have to look at the year over year, month over month numbers in the context of, you know, September of last year, it was a highly inflationary period. October of last year was highly inflationary, and now we're in a deflationary or flat period. So you have to look at things in that context. So people's behavior is changing as the inflation is adjusting by category.
So Mark, remind me, these numbers from the government that they put out, those can change, correct? I mean, will the Retail Monitor numbers also get revised?
Yeah, it's a great point, Bill. You know, because the census numbers are survey-based, they do get revised often several times a year as more data comes in. So when the census releases their data, they don't have all the surveys coming in. And actually what we've seen over time is that the number of people responding to those surveys has decreased as well. The numbers for the Retail Monitor, on the other hand, because they're based on actual transactions, will never be revised. You know, the one thing that, you know, we've seen, you know, when Census releases their revised numbers, as they continue to revise their numbers, is that they actually revise towards what Affinity was already telling us. So if we look at the Census revised numbers and we compare that to the current Retail Monitor numbers, we see an improved correlation of 0.12 as Census gets better data, and their better data shows that what we, again, so what we knew all along, that the Retail Monitor numbers are spot on.
Jonathan, Mark, thank you both so much for these insights. This has been great. I'm incredibly excited about what the future holds for the Monitor, not only as it has been launched just recently, but as it evolves, just as retail does, over the months and the years ahead. Thank you both for being with me.
Thank you so much.
I look forward to many more conversations like this over the next year. For those watching the video, we hope that you found this helpful. And please check back for the next Retail Monitor release in early December. You can find more information at nrf.com. Thanks again for being with us. Until next time.